Now, given a DAG and a way to estimate its execution time, how can I tell if the DAG is good or bad? Let's derive an answer. First, we'll identify a metric of goodness, and then we will optimize the metric. Let's use speedup as our metric. Speedup is defined as the best sequential time divided by the parallel time. In terms of symbols, I'll use T star to denote the best sequential time, and of course we'll use TP of n to denote the parallel time, as before. Now, quick comment about the numerator and the denominator of speedup. The denominator will in general depend on the work, the span, the problem size, and the number of processors. The numerator will depend essentially on the work done by the best sequential algorithm. So for notational consistency, since I'm using work in the case of the parallel algorithm, I'll use another work symbol for the sequential algorithm. The best sequential time will essentially always be equal to the best sequential work. Now, you might be wondering, why am I saying best sequential time? What's special about best? The answer is, I'm a good professor, and I want to make it hard to cheat. After all, you can always make speedup artificially large by choosing a terrible baseline. If any of you are into marketing, you know what I'm talking about. Now, if I give you a PRAM with P processors, then ideally you'd like the parallel algorithm to be P times faster than the best sequential algorithm. This condition is called ideal speedup, or sometimes linear speedup, linear scaling, or ideal scaling. But basically, they all say you want the speedup to be linear in P. Here I'm using big theta notation because you usually won't care about the constant factors, at least not at this pencil and paper algorithm design stage. Now, essentially what this says is if P doubles, then you want SP to also double. Of course, that's an ideal. We might not always achieve it. Let's write speedup in terms of best sequential work and parallel time. Now, in the general case, we can use Brent's theorem to get an upper bound on time and therefore a lower bound on speedup. So let's go ahead and plug in Brent's theorem. For notational ease, I've dropped this paren of n in the right-hand side. Just remember that there's a dependence on n there. Let's do a little bit of algebra on the right-hand side to get it into a form that we can analyze more easily. Okay, written in this form, you can now immediately see what has to be true in order to get ideal scaling. First, notice the numerator, which has the number of processors in it. So relative to this goal, I will pay a penalty, which is determined by the denominator. In other words, if I want to get linear scaling, I need the denominator to be a constant. So what would it take for this to be true of the denominator? Let's look at each term in turn. For this term to be constant, the work of the parallel algorithm has to match the work of the best sequential algorithm. This principle is something we call work optimality. It's a necessary condition to ensure ideal scaling. Intuitively, it prevents another form of cheating. It says that if you get a very parallel algorithm by dramatically increasing the work relative to the best sequential algorithm, then that's actually bad for speedup. Now let's look at the other term in the denominator. For this term to be constant, it essentially says that P should be proportional to W star over D. So this is similar to the idea of the average available parallelism, and the main difference is that we have a W star here instead of just W. Now there's another way to write this. This other way to write it is to say that W star divided by P has to be big omega of D. Let's think about this for a second. W star over P is basically the work per processor. This expression says that the work per processor has to grow, and in particular, it has to grow proportional to the span. And the span, remember, depends on the problem size n. So in other words, this says that the work per processor has to grow as some function of n. In the parallel computing literature, this is called weak scalability. So basically what it says is, as you increase the concurrency of the machine, then if you want to get good scaling, you might need to increase the problem size. Okay, that was a little messy. Let's try to recap the algorithm design goals you just derived. So starting from speedup, we set linear scaling as our goal. Now to achieve linear scaling, you derived two fundamental principles of good parallel algorithm design. The first is work optimality, which says that the work of the parallel algorithm should match the work of the best sequential algorithm. And the second principle is weak scalability. In one interpretation, it basically says that the work per processor should grow as a function of n. and that function is determined by the span